All right, so this is week 22, graphing with slash identifying x and y intercepts. So let's draw some graphs. In the first one here, we're given that the x-intercept is 1 and that y-intercept is 3. So what we're going to do is just draw our, as neat as we can, just draw a coordinate plane. So you have your x-axis, which is always the horizontal one, and then the y, which is always the vertical one. So what is an x-intercept? Really what it is just the spot where the line, the graph, crosses the axis itself. Okay, so the x-intercept is where the graph of the line crosses the x-axis. All right, so the x-axis is right here. So it's gonna be right there at that point. I'll do it in a different color. But yeah, that is where it's gonna cross the x-axis. Okay, for the y, it's gonna cross at 3. So I'm gonna go up positive 3, 1, 2, 3. And then right there, well, I'm gonna go a little higher, 1, 2, 3. And then there is where the y-intercept is gonna be. So you can probably guess what's gonna happen now. You're going to connect these two points, okay? Connect the dots right now, that's all we're doing. So you just draw a line as neatly as you can through those points. Now, you kind of have to label them, right? So you're gonna label that 1, and you're gonna label this 3. So just so I can see, that you know where it is going through. Now, it doesn't have to be perfectly to scale, and I understand that. You're not gonna be able to draw it perfectly to scale all the time. That's okay, it's fine. Just as long as you get the concept, I'm happy, okay? So number 2, our x-intercept is going to be a negative 3, and our y-intercept, where it crosses the y-intercept, is going to be 2. Actually, I'm gonna go negative 2. Let's do that. All right, negative 2. So I'm gonna draw this one down here. Let me make this a little bit larger so you can see it. All right. So our x-intercept is negative 3. So 1, 2, 3 in the negative direction, remembering that we always start at the origin. This is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, and I draw arrows because we know that they go on to infinity. So negative 3 right there, and we stop, okay? That is the x-intercept. How about the y-intercept? It's negative 2. So you're gonna go down 2, 1, 2 on that y-axis right there. So draw the negative 2, or at least label it where it is. Now you're going to connect the dots again, this dot and that dot. And this is graphing just with the intercepts. Okay, so we're gonna do one more. Number 3, your x-intercept is, I'm gonna go 5. And then your y-intercept is gonna be negative 8. Negative 8. Okay, so let's draw this axis here. And sometimes you need to change the scale. But this is what I want you to do, okay? You don't necessarily have to always draw the little tick marks right here. If you wanna try to draw it to scale, that might help, but you don't have to. So for the x-axis, we're gonna go, this is x-axis, this is y-axis, we're gonna be going 5, and I wanna save room because we're gonna be going down 8 in this direction. So I'm gonna just say that this is 5 in this direction, this is all I want you to do, that's 5. And then down here, we go, let's say 5 and then 3 more, and that's negative 8. So here is the y-intercept, here is the x-intercept, and then we just connect the dots, draw that line. And that's all I will expect you to do in your assignment, okay? On a piece of paper. Okay, so the next section we have, given the equation, find the x and y intercepts. But where are the equations? Well, here's the first one. So we're gonna start with number 1 again. We're gonna go x minus 4y equals 20. And here's the trick, okay, you ready? I'm going to write this off to the side. Okay. To find the x-intercept. Okay, so to find the x-intercept, plug in 0 for y and solve for x. Okay. And then in order to find the y-intercept, put a comma there, plug in 0 for x, right? And solve for y, okay? So it's the same thing, okay? You're just changing this here, okay? So I don't know if that was super helpful, but it's really the idea here. Actually, I'll just underline it here. So we'll see this in action in just a second. I just didn't want to write all those words. I don't think it's necessary. To find the x-intercept, plug in 0 for y. To find the y-intercept, plug in 0 for x and solve for y, okay? So we're going to plug in 0 for y in this one to find the x-intercept. So x-intercept, we're going to plug in 0 for y, okay? So x minus 4 times 0 equals 20. That's what you do first. Now you solve for x, okay? Clearly this thing here is gonna be 0. Negative 4 times 0 is 0. So x equals 0. That means our y-intercept is 0, okay? Or excuse me, our x-intercept is 0. Oh no, did I get that right? Yeah, x-intercept is 0. Y-intercept, let's do that one. First we we plug in 0 for x. So 0 for x minus 4y equals 20. And then we just have negative 4y equals 20. And I'll go to the next page here. And then we solve for y. Divide both sides by negative 4. And then y equals negative 5. Okay. So your x-intercept is 20, your y-intercept is negative 5, and that's how you solve it. You plug in 0. That's really the key, is plugging in 0 for the other variable, the other, the other coordinate, okay? Let's try another one. Number 2. Gonna be 3x, we can do this a little bit quicker here. 3x plus 2y equals 18. Okay. So we're going to first find the x-intercept. Going to plug in 0 for y, right? So 3x plus 2 times 0 equals 18. And then we do 3x equals 18. And then divide both sides by 3, right? Like we're solving an equation, and then x equals 6. All right, how about the y-intercept? Y-intercept is plug in 0 for x, okay? So that's where 0 goes. 3 times 0 plus 2y equals 18. 2y equals 18, divide both sides by 2, and then y equals 9. So your x-intercept in this equation is 6 and your y-intercept is 9. Now, if you wanted to, you could graph it from here. So basically, I'm teaching you how to graph this equation on a line based upon finding the x and y-intercepts. All right, now how about this one? 5x minus y equals 15. Okay, let me switch colors here. So you're gonna find the x-intercept first. So you're going to plug in 0 for y. See? Plugged in 0 for y, everybody? Nod your head. Yes, you see. Okay. 5x equals 15. Divide both sides by 5. X equals 3. All right, I'm going to find the y-intercept now. So I'm going to plug in 0 for what? X, right? Plugging in 0 for x. Okay. All right, so now we have 0 minus y equals 15. So we have now negative y equals 15. Now there's a 1 in front here. So we're going to just divide both sides by negative 1 and then realize that y equals negative 15. Whenever you have a negative variable equals a positive number, you just put the negative sign over with the number and then the variable is positive, but you have to have a positive variable. So your x-intercept is 3 and your y-intercept is negative 15. Okay, and I need another page here because there just are so many problems here. So add page. Number 4. Okay, so this is a special type of problem. This is just x equals negative 7. Now you have to know how to do this. Okay, in this situation, we already have the x-intercept right here. Okay, we already have the x-intercept. What is it, everyone? Negative 7. So what does that mean for the y-intercept? Okay, well, that means that the y-intercept is, well, let me just show you. X-intercept is negative 7. Y-intercept, here you go. Ready for this? It's weird, but it doesn't exist. Doesn't exist. How could that be? Well, here's how it works. You have a coordinate plane. You have a coordinate plane, okay? And then you have negative 7 over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, it's over here. Boom. Okay, that's the x-intercept, right? So you're expecting some kind of line. Well, where does it cross the y-axis over here? Where does it cross this y-axis? Well, it never does. Okay, how is that possible? Well, it's because you have a vertical line. You have a vertical line just parallel to the, well, it's not quite vertical now, is it? Parallel line to the y-axis, right like that. And it's right at negative 7. So that's why you don't have a y-intercept, okay? So that would be the case. The y-intercept is not 0. Don't say it's 0, okay? Don't say it's 0 because it's not. It doesn't exist, okay, whenever you have that, okay? Let's see one that's a little similar to that. See a question that's a little similar to this in number 5. Okay, what if you have y equals 8, okay? We have y equals 8. Oh, by the way, this was negative 7 over here, so you label that. Y equals 8. Okay, so the x-intercept in this case would not exist. Or you could put like this. You could just put dne, does not exist. And then the y-intercept would be, you guessed it, 8. So our coordinate plane, in fact, I'm just going to draw this a little farther down here. So it goes up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There it is right there. There's our y-intercept at 8, going up 8. And then it is a horizontal line, right? Horizontal line parallel to this x-axis right here. Here's the y-axis, here's the x-axis, right? So it is a parallel line to the x-axis, okay? So don't get confused here about that. The y equals 8 is right there. X-intercept does not exist. There is no x-intercept.